You'll need a flat bench and a pair of dumbbells for this next program.
A fairly easy variation mountain climber for this exercise. So you can see I'm using the bench to create some elevation and to give me some assistance with it. Make sure your knees are coming all the way through, straight down the middle. Nice and light on your toes for this one. Your turn to try it. Using the tip of the bench for some triceps dips for this exercise. Now you can see I'm doing it with straight legs so that I can't cheat. And you've just got to make sure that your butt stays really close to your hand. We don't want to cause any excess pressure in the rotator cuffs. Your turn to try this one. Working some push-ups for this exercise, and we're getting some assistance from the bench just to create a little bit of elevation, and this will make the push-up fairly easy. Just make sure you're cautious enough not to tip the bench over. Your turn to try this one. Unilateral flat chest press for this one, guys. So you can see I'm holding the left side up and I'm starting my reps with the right side. I'm going to get a bunch in and then I'm going to switch it up and hit the left side as well. And then I'm going to finish off by going bilateral and hitting both sides together. Your turn to try it. bent over unilateral rows for this one. So you can see I'm holding one of my arms right up at my ribs in that finishing position of the rows, and then I'm just doing my reps with my other arm. Now we want to make sure that your elbows are relatively well tucked in and it's just a straight up and down motion. Once you finish this set, switch hands and do the other side as well. Your turn to try it. Unilateral skull crushers for this exercise. So very important to start off with that neutral hand position, just drawing a pair of parallel lines with your arms, and then we're going to hit the skull crushers on one side, making sure you're minimizing any movement in the elbow, and then we're going to hit the other side as well. Then we're going to finish off by doing a bilateral set, so doing both sides at the same time. Your turn to try it. Working some unilateral hammer curls for this one. So very important to keep your elbows tight and tucked in by your side. And you can see that I'm holding isometric on one side and doing my reps on my other side. Having this hammer or neutral hand position is going to really help with hitting not just the biceps, but also your brachialis and lateral triceps to some extent as well. Your turn to try this one. We'll be right back. Okay, nice, difficult variation of some triceps kickbacks for this one. So you can see I'm holding the isometric side in the finishing position of that kickback, which is quite difficult to do, and then I'm hitting the reps with the other side. Got to make sure there's no movement in your elbows and that they're tucked in by your ribs. Let's finish one side and then switch it up and do the other side as well. This one's a nice difficult variation of a lateral delt raise. So you can see my left side is just holding that T position isometric, and then I'm doing my reps with my right. What you got to be really careful with this one is make sure that your wrists don't snap forward. You've got to try and keep them nice and tight the whole time. Make sure the movement stays nice and lateral, and you've got a slight bend in your knees in order to protect your back. Your turn to try this one. We'll be right back. Working some circular shrugs, starting with one side to begin with, and then what we'll do is we'll switch it up and do the opposite side, and then we're going to finish up by doing both sides. So bilateral movement at the end of it. Your turn to try it. Nice difficult variation of some biceps curls. So you can see that I'm holding one side isometric in that contracted position, and I'm just working on the other side. So just the right arm doing all the repetitions. At the end of the set, I'm going to switch it up. I'm going to hold isometric with my right side and get the left to do the reps. Your turn to try this one. Working some L delts rotations for this exercise. Now, this one's a really good rehab exercise. You can see that I'm actually using quite light weights, and this is fantastic for repairing the rotator cuff because what it does is it essentially helps you push your shoulder backwards. You can see that I'm holding isometric with my left side and I'm just working the right. And then at the end of the set, we're gonna switch it up and use the other hand. Your turn to try this one. this exercise is a really difficult variation of some obliques tilts. So you can see what I've done is I've brought my hands over into the start of that shoulder press position, and I'm actually holding it isometric there. So it's going to manipulate the weight, and it's actually going to make the obliques tilts quite difficult. Now, just make sure that your feet are wide enough apart to give you a sturdy stance and to help protect your back as well. Your turn to try this one.
Well done for finishing your workout, guys. Please take a few minutes to stretch and cool your body down now.
If you enjoyed this workout segment, please assist us by liking and sharing. Remember to subscribe for your daily workout fix.